Hey guys, it's Orlando. Today is November 3rd, 2011, and this is my 8-week on testosterone video update. I got my shot yesterday. I met with my doctor, and I have some really great news. When I met with her, we went over my blood work, like I said I was gonna in my last video, and she was really impressed with the total amount of testosterone that I already have. I guess it's already in the mid-hundreds level, which is quite uncommon after being just on a low dose of T for a couple of weeks already. So she decided to up my dosage as well as give me my very own prescription of T to start doing it at home. I was actually quite surprised because normally they tell you that you have to do it at least maybe quite a few times before they let you do it at home, but the nurses were quite impressed with me by how confident I was giving the shot myself. So the doctor was like, "I can tell you're pretty confident, so I'll give you a prescription and you can start doing it at home." So yay for me. Here's what it looks like. I'll show you guys. I was expecting, you know, like those big brown vials that I see a lot of guys have, but this is what mine looks like. It's very, very small. I guess there's a new law in Massachusetts, where I go, that says they can't give you more than a 1 month supply anymore, because the big vials that normally everybody else has are like maybe this big. Those last about 3 to 4 months, but my doctor said, I guess, this new law that they have, it, permits them from doing that. So, I have to get those little vials, and those last about a month, so I'm only allowed 1 month of tea, you know, per vial, I guess. And she also gave me, which is really good, a bag of syringes. There's a total of 11 in here, so it lasts me about 4 shots. And here's what they look like. I'll just show you one of them. This is what it looks like. It's just a regular, it's a 3-milliliter syringe. I'm guessing it's a 1-inch needle, which is not too big. It's the one I've been using in the office. So I had to pay for these because insurance doesn't cover needles, obviously, but my insurance covers the tea, so that's good. So I will be giving my first home self-injection in 2 weeks from now. My dosage was increased to 100 milligrams every 2 weeks instead of the 50 every 2 weeks. She wants to keep me every 2 weeks for now because she's a little concerned about, I guess my blood count was kind of low when I got the blood test done, so she wants to keep a close eye on that. But since my T level, my liver, and my kidneys, everything else was fine, she decided to up the dosage anyway, so I'm really excited about that. I'm probably not going to make a video, doing the self-injection, only because I don't know, I'm kind of iffy about doing that. But if you guys want to see me do one, I'll make one. It's up to you. So anyways, on to the changes. There have been a couple of changes. One in particular I just noticed this morning. Like I said, I did get my shot yesterday, and I hope this isn't T-related, but when I woke up this morning, my knee was hurting. It's on the same leg that I had the injection, but there's no pain whatsoever near the injection site. It's directly on my knee. I don't know why it's hurting, but every time, like, I lift my leg up, every time I bend it, like, all the way, my knee is just, like, it just hurts. Like, it's a mix between, like, it feels like I need to pop it, and it feels like a pulled muscle, so I'm kind of hoping it's just a pulled muscle. I highly doubt it's T-related, because this has never happened before. But yeah, it hurts a lot, like, if I walk up the stairs, or if I just walk in general. I gotta go slow, but I'm kind of hoping that'll go away in a couple of days. But if it's not better by at least Monday or Tuesday, I'll call up my doctor and just ask her what's going on. If any of you guys have experienced that, you know, like, knee pain after a shot, you know, would you, you know, just please let me know, and let me know if it went away on its own or not. Like I said, I hope it's not T-related, but I just thought I would mention it anyway. So anyways, another change, like I mentioned it last time, but my appetite is increasing again. I'm constantly hungry now. I've been eating a lot. My muscles are still growing. My arms are getting a little bit bigger. I've noticed a new change. When I was actually walking to class this morning, I noticed my legs were they were increasingly burning, due to like walking all that time. I guess like since I'm gonna be exercising now, and if I keep walking, like my legs will start to burn. Probably because the muscle is starting to build up in my legs now, like my calves and the front of my legs especially. It was like really, really burning, and it was kind of hurt. So that's a good thing. My legs are starting to develop as well. Energy, since my last shot yesterday, I've been feeling a little bit more energized. And I only got like 4 to 5 hours of sleep last night, and I'm like not even tired, so that says something. Hair, I've noticed on the right side of my face, like right where this line is, I've noticed a little bit of hair is starting to slowly come down, which I'm presuming is the beginning development of my sideburns. It's not happening on this side, just only on my right side, so I'm probably gonna start to get sideburns on this side, and then hopefully eventually on this side too. Mustache still coming in really coarse, really, it's at that point now where I can, you know, I can see the mustache without like having to, you know, go all extra close to the mirror. I can go like really far away and still be able to see it, so that's good. Also, I got more long hairs coming in. You know, like I showed in my last video, I had one right here. I'm starting to get a lot, like, right in this area, like, near my jawbone. My face, I've noticed my face is kind of getting a little bit narrow, just slightly more narrow, and a little bit broad, I guess you could say. But more narrow, I'm guessing. It's starting to get longer and more narrow. And the last change I've noticed is smell. I can really start to smell myself now. My body odor is definitely changing. And I can definitely change. I mean, I can definitely tell a change, rather. Like, if I go to the bathroom, I can definitely smell myself. And my shit definitely, like, smells different. And I'm just gonna come bluntly out and say that. My shit fucking stinks, man. It, like, I've never smelled, like, a more potent smell in my life. Like, it doesn't smell like shit, really. It smells like, I don't even know how to describe the smell. It's just, like, this potent, strong smell. And it's really kind of disturbing in a way. But that's what I've noticed. So that's pretty much it for all the changes for my 8-week. I'll probably make a video maybe Wednesday or Thursday of next week. If you guys have any questions, feel free to comment and inbox me. You know the deal. Hope you guys are doing well, and I will see you guys next week for my next update. See you later.